the storied history of NC State women's basketball, no team has started the season 17-0 until now. Westmore's troops have fashioned the best start in school history and now find themselves as the nation's only undefeated team. They'll look to keep the momentum going against Virginia Tech. Hoops a Sunday afternoon of the ACC, and our matchup this afternoon, it's the Virginia Tech Hokies with their 13-4 record against the number 8 team in the nation, the NC State Wolfpack, 17-0 as we play at historic Reynolds Coliseum. A peek at the standings of the ACC, the number 1 team in the nation, Notre Dame, 5-0 in conference play. The Wolfpack right behind them with their perfect 4-0 record, in Virginia Tech in search of its first conference win today. It is so great to have you with us for our game this afternoon. Tom Wormy along with Chelsea Shine, the former standout in basketball at Virginia. And Chelsea, we'll start with Virginia Tech. Yes, their conference record is 0-4, but this team could easily have a couple of wins in its record in ACC play.
Could easily be 3-1 right now. This is a Virginia Tech team that you have to throw the record away when you're playing them, because they can play much better than their record indicates. And two reasons why. Taylor Emery, one of those reasons, a prolific scorer, one of the best in the ACC. She can score at every level. She can take you off the bounce. She loves the mid-range game, loves to pull up, and that elbow, especially on the right side, can create space, can also shoot from behind the arc. Taylor Emery is a player that you have to slow down if possible. And on the inside, it's Reagan McGarity, averaging a double-double this season, leading the ACC in rebounding. She's tough. She's big. Can also score from the outside. So this is a player that will stretch the defense. You have to respect her shot from the outside as well.
44 career double-double. Doubles for McGarity, and that is a Virginia Tech school record. For NC State, they have had to deal with some significant injuries. We will document that story in just a moment, but right now this game is underway. NC State in the white and red, and the Hokies in the traveling maroon with the orange trim. There is no team in all of college basketball undefeated other than the team you're watching this afternoon, the NC State women's program under Wes Moore. Rogers came in after the miss. McGarity tied her up, and the arrow will favor Virginia Tech.
We've got one of the best rebounding teams in the country. Certainly in the conference is NC State, but it'll be a fun battle to watch between Reagan McGarity and Dee Dee Rogers. Talk about McGarity averaging a double-double, almost 13 boards a game she gets. Those two will be fun to watch on the interior.
First points of the game for Virginia Tech come from Baptiste. Early moments of the first quarter. The series has been dominated by NC State, 18-1 in the previous 19 meetings, but two trips down the court for the Pack, and they've come up empty.
It's a really good look inside. Cassell has been playing well for NC State, picking up the slack. We talk about injuries, and those are some players that you're seeing elevate their game, getting a lot more minutes.
Emery got the defender in the air and hits the shot.
So smooth. She loves the elbow. You'll see her pull up from there all afternoon. She can create space. Look, you saw how close Leslie was on her, but you get a defender off their feet, that's an easy two for Emery.
Emery, who averages almost 19 points per game, that is third best in the ACC, and shoots 45% from the floor. Rogers got cut off on the baseline and then traveled as Baptiste and McGarity were there. Time for the Toyota starting lineups. And for these Hokies, 13-4 on the season. Emery, their leading scorer. McGarity, leading rebounder in the conference. Baptiste, Mabry, also in that starting lineup for the Hokies. Emery's shot altered by the defending of Leslie. NC State without its leading scorer, Grace Hunter, injured in the game at home against Duke. Wes Moore, his Toyota starting lineup, and Kai Crutchfield has come in for Hunter and started the last four games and done a commendable job in that starting lineup for the Wolfpack.
Em picked up her first personal foul.
One way to slow Emery down is to send her to the bench, and one way to do that is getting her into early foul trouble. It's a big drive by Leslie to pick up that early foul.
NC State coming off a victory a week ago at Virginia, 66-38. They dominated the boards, but shot the three poorly, only made 6 of 27. They don't need it on that trip. From the interior, they've got two with Castell. NC State as a team, third best in the conference. They shoot 46% up and down the roster. Inside, McGarity behind her defender. Baptiste found her for two.
Baptiste is getting more comfortable in a starting role. She had come off the bench most of the season, past two games into a starting lineup, had 16 boards in their game against Notre Dame. I mean, this is a tough player, and the more comfortable she's getting, you're seeing the way she can affect the game with an assist there.
Inside the three-point stripe, but two for Leslie. Chelsea, you mentioned for Virginia Tech, its last game Wednesday at home against number one Notre Dame, and a loss 80-51. McGarity had it blocked. Rogers. Crutchfield brings it up. That's a three-point attempt. High rebound to Baptiste after the miss from Cassell. Virginia Tech only shot 31% in the loss against Notre Dame. They won their first 13 games of the season, but trying to snap a four-game losing streak, and all of those games and losses have come in conference play.
We talk about the injuries and this undefeated NC State team, and it's so impressive what Wes Moore has done, because they're undefeated in the face of so much adversity. Grace Hunter was their leading scorer before getting injured in that game, their first conference game against Duke. You can see the players that are out. That guard spot missing a lot of faces that could be contributing, and the fact that they're undefeated still is just so impressive. Wes Moore doing a great job moving pieces around, and credit to his players for stepping up and elevating their game amidst all of that.
Koenig, fancy dribble, three-point attempt with the shot clock running down. It goes out of bounds off of NC State as Leslie tried to get to it. Coach Wes Moore, sixth season, 30th overall. He is approaching 700 career victories, but some key players sitting on the bench for Coach Moore. And you mentioned Hunter, responsible for almost 15 points per game, but injured four games ago against Duke late in that victory against the Blue Devils for NC State. It was fall away from Baptiste. Knocked out of bounds. It will be Virginia Tech basketball.
Big hustle play by Emery. Didn't secure the rebound, but tipped it off of NC State to keep the possession.
Straight away for three. Shepherd for Virginia Tech.
Virginia Tech is a good three-point shooting team. Second in the league in three-pointers made per game, just over nine. Their entire starting lineup is capable from behind the arc.
And Shepherd is one of three players on the roster with over 100 made threes in their career, and she gets the rebound. Kendall Brooks leads the way with 146 made threes, and that's fifth in school history for Brooks. He is currently on the bench right now for the Hokies. Knocked away and stolen. Crutchfield. Fight for the loose ball. And a traveling violation as Cassell grabbed it but traveled. The Bell Tower here on campus in Raleigh. And the Wolfpack trailing the visiting Hokies 9-4 early in the first. Hokies with the early lead in the first quarter with 4:29 to go. We take a look at their season so far. Again, they came out of the gates for Coach Brooks and won their first 13 games and some close losses in ACC play. 0-4, Chelsea.
Yeah, we keep saying this is a team that could be 3-1. They lost at Miami early on when Miami was in the top 25. They lost to Syracuse in overtime, ranked in the top 25, then went down to play their rival Virginia, and they lost a 19-point lead in that game. And Certainly not an easy stretch coming now again. Played Notre Dame, we talked about on Wednesday. Now your back-to-back top 10 opponents this afternoon against the 8th-ranked NC State Wolfpack.
And the only undefeated team, men or women, in the nation. As the two undefeateds yesterday, Virginia, sorry Chelsea, and Michigan, both went down to defeat. So NC State, the only team without a blemish. McGarity, quick first step, blocked and recovered nicely defensively. Kunane.
Kunane, the freshman, getting a lot more minutes than most freshmen do, having to have an immediate impact. Doing a good job there. She's 6'5", has a slight height advantage over McGarity.
McGarity beat the shot clock over Kunane, and she's got four. McGarity's name is all over the Virginia Tech record books. Almost 1,000 points, over 1,000 rebounds, a school record 1,075 boards. And that figure is 7th among all of active NCAA players.
Redshirt senior, I mean, she at this point in her career is used to the double teams, the triple teams, figuring out how to score over bigger players. As a big, strong take by Leslie. Leslie, another player who I think will continue to heat up as this game goes on. Another prolific scorer, can score in a variety of ways, has really stepped up her game. Had over 30 points earlier this season against Boston College. Very capable scorer.
NC State had missed its previous four field goals. Leslie, the graduate student from Holly Springs, North Carolina. Kunane, fine defense. Shepherd trying to drive to the rim. Now we're inside with 3 minutes to go in our first quarter of play. Koenig dribbles the daylight and hits it.
Koenig has been running the point a lot more with Ely out this season, and Coach Moore's put in some plays to try to get her to score from the point guard position. Has done a great job, he said, taking over that spot.
She did struggle, though, in their most recent game and victory at Virginia. Had just 5 points, and Koenig was only 1 of 6 from three-point distance. Shot clock is at 6. Shepherd hoists one and hits it. At least 4 feet behind the line for Shepherd, who now has 6.
Well, Coach Moore not happy about that on the sideline, especially when you've got 5 seconds left on the shot clock. He wanted a hand up.
Second three of the game for Shepherd. Leslie driving against McGarity.
Next trip down, I think NC State has to go right back to that now. When Leslie is in the open court and can score to the basket, that's easy offense.
Rogers, basket and foul.
This is where NC State gets some easy offense in transition. Dede Rogers, a post player, adding a little versatility to her game, and she's had to do so in light of the injuries. Coast to coast for the post player.
Rogers, the senior from Charlotte, North Carolina, right down the road. Averaging just over 4 points per game. She's got the old school three-point play. How about her game in early December at Georgetown for Dede Rogers? 20 rebounds, a career high for her.
We have elite
Needless
rebounders.
To say, right?
Right. We've got elite rebounders in this game across the board for both teams. And Taylor Emery, I mean, she can score on balance, off balance, shoulders square, shoulders not square. Just about any shot is within her repertoire for Emery.
Led the team with 15 points in the losing effort against Notre Dame at home. Koenig catch and release. Kunane offensive glass had it knocked away and it rolls to Shepherd. Dara Mabry, the freshman from Belmar, New Jersey, wearing number 4 in maroon. Comes from a very talented basketball family. Dede Rogers does as well, and she makes the steal. Kunane back and down. does not get the bounce. 25 seconds to go in the quarter.
NC State working a lot of four out, one in, which gives the option to the guards on the outside to drive, or as you saw there, Cunane to work one-on-one on the interior. Now the Hokies will be able to hold it for the last shot.
Told you Shepherd's made 2 threes. She missed all three of her three-point attempts in the home game against Notre Dame. Takes a glance at the clock and hits Henry, knocked away by Leslie. Crutchfield trying to beat that clock. Straight away, three! How about that first quarter of action, Chelsea Shine? 16-13, Hokies and Wolfpack on ACC College Hoops.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by Toyota. Visit your local Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places. And Hardee's. Try the new Angus Thick Burger Melts. Hardee's, because it tastes better.
The statue of the legend Kay Yao outside of Reynolds Coliseum. And inside we play on Kay Yao Court. 34 years as the head coach of this Wolfpack women's program. And Chelsea, 680 wins. And she touched so many lives while she was with us. Gone too soon, obviously, but her memory certainly lives on, especially here in Raleigh. Leslie inside.
Leslie, so effective. Another guard that can score at every level and impacts the game, not just on the offensive end, but she's a great rebounder and a great defender.
Mabry misses. Cunane had the rebound. Leslie's got 9 points as we start the second quarter. She is a double-digit scorer for NC State, averaging 14.4 points per game. And she's their leading rebounder. She's got the ball now. Did you see that little head shimmy shake? To the basket for two, Leslie, double digits.
She just reads the defense. She sees what she wants to get, takes her time. She's patient. Efficient score.
15th time this season she's gotten double digits. This is game number 18 for NC State. Spinning and scoring for Virginia Tech. It's Rachel Camp. Her first basket of the afternoon for Camp, a senior from Forest City, North Carolina. Inside and two. Conan.
Really good read off the screen. NC State's been much more effective going to the rim. Have been a little cold shooting from the outside, but the more they've been able to put the ball on the floor or get the ball inside with a pass, they've found success.
Mabry on the drive. Baptiste was closest to it. If there was a foul on the play, it was Baptiste.
Aislinn Koenig, you watch her here pass, come off that flare screen, and reads the defense, has a step, good back door.
Koenig, close to 12 points per game this season, the junior from Surrey, British Columbia, Canada. She's working on a streak of 50 straight made threes, making 51.
In the nation in terms of that streak. You mentioned it, 1 for 6 in their game against Virginia, but you got to be careful. You got every possession she has the ball from behind the arc, you have to treat it as if she's made the last five. Is Kendall Brooks, the daughter of Virginia Tech head coach Kenny Brooks, now knocks down a triple.
So Koenig has now hit a three in 51 straight games. It is the longest streak of that nature in the nation. Gonna get Brooks on the foul for Virginia Tech. It's Kendall Brooks' first foul.
Here's Koenig again, finding some separation. Drills the triple.
Continues to climb the ranks. And career three-pointers. Leslie, who hasn't missed much, misses out of the corner. And Shepherd covers for Virginia Tech. NC State has not committed a foul as we play into the second quarter. In and out for Brooks. It's despite that miss, Brooks now with 147 career-made threes, and that's fifth in school history. Whistle underneath, remain against McGarrity. First personal on McGarrity. Emery is back into the lineup for the Hokies. Jones for three. McGarrity had the rebound and went off her hands and off her knee and out of bounds.
It's one of those frustrating plays.
Third season for Kenny Brooks. 56 wins as the head coach for the Hokies. 17th year overall as a head coach, and he is closing in on 400 career victories. Such success at James Madison for Kenny Brooks, 337 career wins there. That's the most in the history of that program.
He's done a great job wherever he's been, and you've seen the success that this program has had at Virginia Tech, especially that non-conference record. They've been so consistent. Certainly the ACC is a different animal when getting into conference play.
Coach Brooks, four times the Coach of the Year in the Colonial Athletic Association. A men's assistant at JMU and VMI. And he played at JMU 3 years for Lefty Drizel. Might have picked up a couple of things in those 3 years of playing. Leslie snares that one. Inside Poonin, it's an easy two.
That was a great pass inside by Jones to get it to the freshman where she could score easily right in step with her momentum.
NC State has taken a three-point lead. Emery fenced in. Brooks, keep an eye on that shot clock. It's down to five for Baptiste for three.
Well, Virginia Tech is just making some big plays. As the clock's winding down, NC State has to find a way to lock down through the full 30 seconds of the shot clock, and Virginia Tech is finding success out of some broken plays.
Hokies are now 4 of 8 from beyond the arc. NC State just 1 of 6. Koenig has that three-pointer. Rogers tried to field that pass. It goes out of bounds. It is Hokie basketball.
Here's that pass on the inside from Jones to Kunain. You see, passes it right to her hand on the inside. Makes it easy for her to just step and score right in rhythm. And as a post player, that's so important. The less work your post has to do, the easier and more efficient they can be.
Virginia Tech had built a lead in the first quarter. Koenig again for three. Same spot, same result. And double digits now for Koenig. Koenig's now 2 for 4 from three-point distance. She's up to 57 made threes, best in the conference. Driving bucket, Baptiste, Virginia Tech, and she's got 7.
How versatile has Baptiste been? We've seen her take it off the bounce. She's had some assists. It's been effective in their offense.
Hokies hanging with the only undefeated team in the country. The name on the entry, knocked away by Baptiste. So there is a timeout on the court.
Well, Aislinn Koenig, beaten up from the outside, knocks down her second triple from behind the arc to give NC State a one-point lead.
All smiles inside Reynolds Coliseum. What a great Sunday afternoon for women's college basketball in the ACC. At NC State, first in so many categories in those statistics in the conference.
Yeah, well, Coach Moore talks about defense and rebounding being two big pieces for this NC State team, and you can see how effective they are defending and then rebounding. First in the ACC, in all of those categories.
That rebounding margin is also fifth best in the country for NC State. Opponent, shot clock winding down. DeeDee Rogers earns another possession for the Wolfpack. He'll work quickly with Jones. Cassell, rather, trying to step around McGarity. Seventh turnover of the first half. Virginia Tech led by as many as seven in the first quarter. That's an accomplishment in and of itself. Coming into the game, NC State in conference games had only trailed for about 6 minutes all season in their first four conference games. Whistle prior to the shot. Three-second violation against Virginia Tech. Koenig and Leslie have been the main scoring sources. They've combined for 20 points, hit a couple of threes. How about another? 13 points, Koenig.
Well, that's well executed. You just watch Koenig running off the screens. You credit her teammates for setting that up as well, but just running her through some screening action, getting her to wide open space.
Koenig's now up to 179 career threes, sixth in NC State score history.
Talk about that defense for NC State. Now back-to-back possessions. They're locking down some quick turnovers.
As you saw, they hold opponents to just over 55 points per game. Best mark in the ACC. There is a reason this team, despite some key injuries, is 17-0 this season. Crutchfield hoists the three and knocks it down.
Well, players have been stepping up for NC State. Three key players for NC State. They're players that have had to pick up the slack, pick up the scoring effort. Ty Crutchfield hadn't started a game prior to Grace Hunter going down, and she started the last three in a row. This was her fourth start, making the most of it. And again, this is where you credit Coach Moore for the ability he's done to move pieces around and for the players to step up.
Koenig has 11 of the last 16 points for Westmore and NC State. Ty Crutchfield, you mentioned those starts in the last four games in place of Hunter, the sophomore from right here in Raleigh and Millbrook High School, knocking down that three ball. NC State started 1 of 6 from three-point distance. They have made their last three three-point attempts in a row, and they've got their largest lead of the ball game.
Emery has been quiet. I think you need to get the ball in her hands. She needs to have a go at the basket. So integral, and now another turnover for Virginia Tech, a traveling violation. Virginia Tech's offense runs through Emery and it runs through McGarity, and those two players, we haven't seen them knock down a shot in a stretch.
Approaching the 2 minute mark of the second quarter. Exciting and entertaining first half of basketball between the Hokies and the Wolfpack. It'll stay with NC State. Dee Cantner, Kevin Dillard, and Timothy Bryant are our officials for this afternoon's game. Koenig comes up short. That's a rare miss in the quarter. It had been 8 of 11 prior to that miss by Koenig from the floor for the Wolfpack. McGarity. Emery. McGarity. Three ball is too strong. Crutchfield.
Watch Emery, had a mismatch on her that last possession with Cassell guarding her. That's where you'd think she would take it off the bounce, try to attack the post player.
Leslie driving, drew defensive attention and a double team. Shot clock down to 10. Koenig, three, side rim, and Brooks. Final minute of the first half. ...48% shooting from the floor for Virginia Tech in this first half. It'll fall. Chance at a three-point play. Rachel Camp.
Rachel Camp turns the corner on Aislinn Koenig. Just through contact. Able to finish.
Despite the miss, Camp 81% from the line. Can't finish off the three-point play. We've got 30 seconds to go in our second quarter. About a five-second difference, shot and game. Leslie slips down. Three Hokies surround her, and the arrow will favor Virginia Tech with 6.3 seconds to go.
Coach Brooks going to bring in his three-point specialist now, and Mabry and Shepard. You can expect to see an opportunity from behind the arc here with six to go. Every player on the court for Virginia Tech capable from behind the arc.
Mabry, cross midcourt. Puts up the three. Rattled out for Mabry. So Westmore's team will take the lead, 33-28. To the locker room. Undefeated with the halftime lead this season, the Wolfpack 13-0. Halftime on ACC College Hoops. When we come back, we'll talk about the Brooks sisters playing for their father, Kenny, the sister act for the Hokies. It's halftime from Raleigh and Reynolds Coliseum. This is the Hardys halftime report. NC State on its home floor, K-Yao Court, has a five-point lead against the visiting Hokies from Virginia Tech, 33-28. Kenny Brooks, an interesting dynamic on his bench. He coaches his daughters Chloe and Kendall. It's the family dynamic that is Virginia Tech women's basketball.
I've never coached them until now. Ironically, my wife was the eighth grade girls basketball coach at her middle school, and she coached them. All right, and she actually taught them as well. Other than the getting in the gym and shooting and, you know, stuff like that, you know, I didn't do that. And when they were coming out, and they were both being recruited, you know, at different levels, and I left it up to them. It's unprecedented. You know, I know a lot of people have coached one kid. I don't know if anyone's coached two kids, and especially at the same time. But, you know, it's one of those things. People say, well, how's it going to work? How's it going to affect you? No one knows, all right? In 5 years, I'll write a book, all right? I'll write a book and let everybody know how it happened, how it worked out. But the one thing about it, I think that you have to look at the dynamic, you have to look at the kids. And people ask me a lot, well, how is it coaching your daughters? I think the bigger question and a bigger issue that's made it work is how my daughters have handled the situation. They've come in and they don't want any special treatment. They want to be part of the group, part of the girls. They work extremely hard. They are coaches' kids, so they do know, you know, some of the antics or why you do things, so they understand that. They've been good for the locker room in that aspect, but the locker room's been good to them.
So give a lot of credit to Mom, Chrissy, for coaching the daughters early on, and now both Chloe and Kendall, who's made a three in this game, on the bench for Kenny Brooks.
Yeah, what an interesting dynamic, and one that, as Coach Brooks alluded to, can be challenging. It's an adjustment not only for Dad, Coach Brooks, and the daughters, but everybody on the team. You've got two players that are his daughters, and so you have to adjust to that. But obviously, it's working really well, and you see the dynamic. You watch him coach his girls, and you can see the passion he has, the passion they have, and what a cool thing for the entire family to be a big part of this entire team.
Yeah, Coach Brooks Wolfpacks took his program all the way to the women's NIT finals, the championship game last year, and they've gone to that tournament three straight years. Kendall Brooks knocking down a three. It's a 5-point difference at halftime on the Hardys Halftime Report. Back on the Hardys Halftime Report, it's a 5-point lead for NC State here at Reynolds Coliseum. Renovated. Beautiful facility for college basketball. And in the first half, NC State was struggling from beyond the arc, but ended up with four makes, and Koenig had three of them.
Yeah, Aislinn Koenig, 3-for-6, efficient from behind the arc. Kai Crutchfield also knocking down a big triple to sort of change the momentum, you felt like that shot did, and giving NC State that 5-point lead. You can see the stats there. Both teams shooting it at a high clip. I think one of the biggest differences, Taylor Emery, the third leading scorer in the ACC, has 4 points. She's only attempted 4 shots. I think that's a number you need to see get higher if you're Virginia Tech. She should have the ball in her hands shooting a lot more than that. Reggie McGarity only has 4 points as well. So two players I expect to see have a lot more offensive output here in the second half if Virginia Tech wants to close this gap. Second half coming up next, NC State with a 5-point lead.
The Greensboro Coliseum is the home of the ACC Women's Tournament. The 14-game, 5-day event begins on March 6th. Ticket books for all the games, just $99. To purchase your tournament tickets, visit Ticketmaster.com. All roads lead to Greensboro in the ACC Women's Tournament for the 18th time in the history of the event, which was played twice right here at Reynolds Coliseum in 1979 and 1982. Chelsea Shine, it's a 5-point lead for the NC State Wolfpack, who shot 61% from the floor in that second quarter.
Yeah, shooting much more efficiently, knocking down some big triples. Kiara Leslie was very efficient as well, 5-for-7. She did a great job attacking the basket, locking down defensively. It will be important for Reagan McGarity and Taylor Emery to be more involved in the offense. That's what the offense runs through, is those two players.
Koenig and Leslie combining for 23 points in the first half of action. This is Koenig. Made three threes in the first half. Got by Brooks and was fouled.
You have to come out with a hand high on Koenig. But she's also very capable of putting the basketball on the floor, as you saw there. And so good job by Koenig mixing it up, reading what the defense is giving her.
Koenig missed her first free throw of the season right there. She had been 2-for-2 prior to that. She's got 14 points now. The three threes brings her up to 58 for the season, best in the conference. Rogers, a near steal at midcourt. McGarity recovers for Virginia Tech.
How effective is Rogers defensively? She can play. She's in the 4 spot with this lineup, but you'll see her. We've seen her play the 3 spot some. So she can get up there, get her hands in the passing lane, create some steals.
Shot clock at 1. Emery travels. Another turnover for Kenny Brooks and the Hokies. They had 8 turnovers in the first half, and NC State turned that into 11 points. Virginia Tech just 2 points off of 8 NC State turnovers.
Well, some of those turnovers, they were unforced. Those travel calls, those are the ones you can't afford against the 8th-ranked team in the country. How good is Kiara Leslie? Just so opportunistic, doesn't force it. I mean, she's the definition of a player who lets the game come to her. She's done a great job so far, being really efficient with her shot selection. 5-for-8, 6-for-8 now.
12 points now for Leslie. Mabry dribbles right to the rim and lays it in. So she was held scoreless in the first half. She's into the box score now in the third quarter.
And Mabry had been struggling from behind the arc, so good job to put it on the floor and try to get a higher percentage shot.
Rebound into the corner. Rogers and McGarity fight for that one, and Rogers wins the battle. Now knocked away and stolen. Baptiste. One on three. Waiting for reinforcements. Mabry. Cassell had the rebound off the miss. 6-point lead for NC State. Led by as many as seven late in the second quarter. Rogers lining up for three. Edie Rogers has only made one three this season, and now one of 12 in three-point attempts. Miscommunication. Brooks got it back. McGarity determined to get to the glass, and she lays it in.
McGarity so good off the bounce. We'll see if Virginia Tech can continue to utilize her.
Garrity's up to 6 points, trying to defend Koenig for three. Angular rebound and taken in by Crutchfield.
And you're seeing why NC State is such a good rebounding team, and it's not even securing the ball, it's just saving possessions. Aislinn Koenig, I mean, way, way too much time and space for Koenig to get that off.
17 points now for Koenig. McGarity couldn't answer with a three of her own. Crutchfield buying some time as her teammates enter the offensive fray. Working that shot clock down to 10. Crutchfield. Attempted save as Cassell went into the front row on the baseline. Hokies got it. Hokies and Pack keeping up the intense level of play. Fouled on the shot was Emery.
Well, Leslie trying to recover quickly. She got stuck on the screen for Emery. It's going to be 3 points at the, or three attempts now, at the free throw line for Emery. And you look at Emery and 4 points in the first quarter, but has not scored since. She's so good. We talk about it creating space, but she has to have the ball in her hands and the flow of the offense, able to attack to be able to do that. Once this season has she not scored in double figures.
She had a season high 27 points in the overtime loss against Syracuse. Michelle leaves the lineup for NC State.
And in their last game against Virginia, she scored the first 17 points of the game.
Lane violation. Emery will get to repeat the process. Predictable reaction from Westmore. Animated on those sidelines. Seven points now for Emery. And those free throws were numbers 2, 3, and 4 in the game for Virginia Tech. They only attempted one free throw in the first half. And they missed that attempt. Rogers thinking about three again. This time it's gone in.
NC State can stretch the floor because their 4 and 5 players are also capable at shooting from behind the arc. So you have to respect them. Pulls the defense out.
Three-second violation against Virginia Tech.
So these are the little possessions throughout the duration of a game where they're going to mount up and could come down depending how close this game stays. down the stretch, these are the possessions and the turnovers that are unforced that you're not going to be able to get back that could end up being the difference.
That three on the last trip down the court by Rogers, just the seventh of her career for the senior from Charlotte, North Carolina, playing in her 111th game in an NC State uniform. Fighting for the loose ball, it's won by Camp, who just came into the game for Virginia Tech. Hokies hanging with the number 8 team in the nation and the only team in college basketball undefeated. But Garrity kicks it back out. Mabry for three.
Shooter's got to keep shooting. And Mabry, who's been struggling in this game from behind the arc, you, as I mentioned, you have to respect a shooter. Finally connecting on one.
She's now 1 of 4 from beyond the arc for Dara Mabry. The freshman who won a couple of state championships in high school in New Jersey.
Well, Mabry trying to keep Virginia Tech in the game. Knocks down a triple. Pulls it to just a 4-point lead for NC State. We've got a close one in Raleigh.
Our hearty star to watch this afternoon is Aislinn Koenig. She's got 17 points. She leads all scorers.
Well, she's got a couple of twos, but most of her made baskets have been from behind the arc. She's 4 for 8, 6 for 12 from the field, and Koenig is a huge reason why the Wolfpack has the lead. So effective. We talked about she struggled in their last game against Virginia, just 1 for 6 from the field, but a very, very capable three-point scorer. You have to have a hand up at all times. She's made 5 three-pointers is her season high in a game this season. She has 4 so far today.
Attempting to make her 5th three, came up short. It's going to be off of Rogers. Koenig is up to 59 made threes on the season. She made 91 last year to set a school record. Garrity, tough shot, well defended by Rogers. NC State has cooled off shooting just a bit, right around 45% for the game. Koenig, Kunane. Ball did not hit the rim, no reset on the shot clock, which is now down to 6. Pass to Kunane, too far and intercepted.
Well, that's the right idea. Kunane did have the defender sealed for a second. Leslie just too late with that pass.
Virginia Tech maintains possession. Goes for three, and they cash it in. Jean for three.
Well, Jean coming into the game has been battling some injuries, and no hesitation there.
Just the 5th game all season in which she has seen action, and just her 2nd made three of the year for Alexis Jean.
Jean, I mean, she's a couple steps off of the line. Just sticks it.
She missed the first 13 games of the season with a shoulder injury. She did play against Notre Dame on Wednesday, 7 minutes, but did not attempt a shot. Importantly, the lead has been reduced to just a point for NC State. Koenig ran into a roadblock and turned it over.
The passes into Kunane have not been great. She's working hard down there trying to keep position, but at 6'5", most times you want to get that ball up high to her, and if it's going to be a bounce pass, it has to be delivered right into her pocket where she can catch it easily.
Shot clock at 10, inside of 2 minutes to go in the quarter. This is Camp. Hokies trying to take the lead. Camp did not get the angle on the square and end. Whistle and foul. It's going to be on Camp. The first. Coming up after our game, more ACC women's basketball. Check your local listings for North Carolina and Miami. Tar Heels posting a win at home against Wake Forest on Thursday, but Janelle Bailey, one of their top scorers and rebounders, will not be in the starting lineup. Bailey fouled out of the game against Wake Forest and picked up a late technical, so Sylvia Hatchell will not start Bailey in that game. That's coming up after us. So once again, Hokies with a chance to take the lead. They have not led since early in the second quarter. They led 18-17. Emery wants three, and she's got it, and the Hokies go in front by two.
I've been surprised she hasn't been looking to be more aggressive, and just a play call action there for Emery. That's really important, I think, for her confidence, just to see a triple go down. They need her in this game to score in this final quarter, going into the fourth.
10 points now for Emery. It's a 9-0 run for Virginia Tech. Leslie, the turnaround front rim and a foul. Guarded by McGarity, who picks it up.
Setting a little rub screen for her, and we talked about it. Emery's so good at creating just enough space to get her shot off. Koenig with the hand up too, but Emery able to get that off. Leslie misses the first one.
67% from the stripe on the season for Kiera Leslie. Had a double-double in that win a week ago at Virginia. One of two from the line, cuts the lead to one. 45 seconds to go, and now 13 points for Leslie. Emery again. Back iron for three in the long, rebound to Leslie. Does not have the numerical advantage, and it doesn't matter.
Well, that is the same exact play for Emery. Doesn't make it, and how about that move by Leslie? I mean, she is just athletic and tough. Can get to the rim. Impressive.
Final 8 seconds. Shot clock is off for the Hokies. Trailing by one. Double team, broke it up. Virginia Tech does not get a shot away on their final possession of the third quarter.
We have got a game, ladies and gentlemen. Kiera Leslie to give NC State the one-point lead. To the fourth we go.
Ready to start the fourth with the Wolfpack ahead of the Hokies, 45-44. Tom Wormy, Chelsea Shine as we go around the ACC.
We see some early scores. Louisville playing at Wake Forest. Boston College at Notre Dame. Not an easy place to play. North Carolina, Miami, the game coming up right after ours.
Miami 3-1 in conference play, and North Carolina got its first conference win on Thursday at home against Wake Forest. That's coming up after us on a big Sunday of ACC Women's College Basketball. Emery against two defenders. Came up short. Rogers came in for it, out of bounds. And Hokie basketball, 9 on the shot clock.
That's the look you want. You want Emery going to the rim. That's a good look.
Emery is the only Hokie into double digits. She's got 10 points. Whistle with the shot clock at 4. Cassell picks up her first. More importantly, though, that's a reset of the shot clock for the Hokies. It was down to 4. Brooks stepping back. Long distance 3. Kendall Brooks.
Koenig gambled for that one, trying to get into the passing lane. Didn't get it, which allowed Brooks to have a ton of space to get that off.
NC State has made just one of its last 6 field goal attempts. Spinning and off the front rim, and the miss from Cassell. Virginia Tech in front. NC State is 17-0. The undefeated record in some serious jeopardy in the fourth.
the triple. There's her sister, as we talked about, cheering on from the bench.
Kendall and Chloe Brooks. You heard Coach Kenny Brooks credit his wife Chrissy for the early basketball teaching of the daughter duo. McGarity. McGarity wants it back. Jean can't get it to her. Baptiste miscalculates the shot. 3 and 4 players go to the deck for the hell ball situation. It's packed basketball. Zonigan Leslie responsible for 32 points. Wes Moore's been around this game a long time. 30 years, 28 of those winning seasons. 15 years as the head coach at Chattanooga, took that program to the NCAA tournament 9 times. Leslie's got 3.
Just a complete miscommunication for Virginia Tech's defense. I mean, Leslie just dribbled off the screen and had no defender on her.
Virginia Tech. Emory the miss. A 1-point lead for NC State. Wolfpack program all the way to the Sweet 16 a season ago. Lost in the semis of the ACC tournament to eventual champion Louisville. Shot clock at 7.
How much does she affect this game? It's not just offense. She's a defender. She's a rebounder. She's done a tremendous job on Emory so far today, limiting her. It felt like that would have been an absolute dagger, and forcing Coach Brooks to call a timeout now as he'll want to chat things over. NC State now with a 4-point lead, but Kiara Leslie is feeling it. NC State with the momentum right now as they have the lead.
Back out in front, 51-47, 6:45 to go in regulation. Kenny Brooks and the Hokies started the season 13-0. They've lost 4 in a row, all in conference. And the first 3 ACC losses were by a combined 13 points. How will they finish this year, this game, and this season?
Yeah, and we talked about how easily they could be 3-1. A tough game against Notre Dame, but the other 3 games, absolutely within winning advantage for them. And Coach Brooks said they totaled up the 120 minutes played in those first 4 games. And he said he felt like his team outplayed the opponent 100 of those minutes as Baptiste hits a 3. And so it's just a matter of finishing games down the stretch. And now Virginia Tech back in an opportunity now to finish a game, and a challenge for his team that I know he's tasked them with, and is something he's really tried to focus on, is putting a full 40 minutes together.
Baptiste with that bucket now has 10 points. You go back to December of 2015, they beat number 8 Tennessee. Last time they defeated the top 10 team, NC State, the number 8 team in the nation. They've gotten 21 points from Kiara Leslie. That's the 4th time this season she's gone for 20 or more. NC State 4 of 9 from beyond the arc in the second half. Leslie wants another. Won't get it this time, but they will get a recycled shot clock. It's their 10th offensive rebound in the game, but they've only produced 3 points off of those rebounds. Koenig misfires. Rogers, another chance for the pack. Her pass went off Cassell, back to her to preserve the possession.
Another chance, and we talk about how good NC State is at rebounding, and when you two second chance opportunities, you're most likely going to convert, as Cassell does with an easy bucket inside.
Traveling against Baptiste.
Taylor Emery has gotten Kiara Leslie off her feet quite a few times now, or any of the defenders, and I'm surprised she hasn't gone up into the defense, or when she does have that space, take more of those jump shots. She hit some early in the first quarter.
Groening, and to send it back out. Inside of 5 minutes to go now in the fourth. Crutchfield to drive. Too strong to McGarity.
You see McGarity bring it up the court. This is a player that has played all different positions and played some point for them last year. Is a capable ball handler. She will bring the ball up the floor.
Baptiste. Shot clock at 8 for McGarity on the drive against two defenders. It's an offensive foul against the driving McGarity, and her third personal. Timeout on the court. Westmore and the Pack trying to preserve the undefeated record. It's a 3-point game of the fourth.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the ACC. Geico. New York Life. Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. Food Lion. And Toyota.
What an afternoon of basketball. NC State, Virginia Tech, 3-point lead for the Pack. Cassell, one dribble in the basket.
Out of a timeout, well-executed play, drawn up by Coach Moore. Good job by Cassell inside to finish that.
Virginia Tech had led by 2 earlier in the quarter. NC State has built a 5-point advantage. Brooks cutting into it with a 3.
The 3 ball has been a big part of this game. Virginia Tech knocking down some key ones. Brooks' second one coming at a big time.
Rogers misses. Crutchfield comes away with it.
NC State dominating the boards right now. That's their 12th offensive rebound of the game.
Virginia Tech, chance to tie or go ahead with a 3. McGarity wants one. Into Koenig's hands. McGarity was going for the big money to take the lead. Cassell steps around the defender and lays it off the glass.
Cassell is a player who played behind Chelsea Nelson and Akilah Mays for a couple of seasons, bided her time, and now the role that she has on this team is so important. She's been playing so well as of late.
Cassell has scored the last 6 points for NC State. And Virginia Tech comes back with a 3 from Baptiste.
The Hokies have responded every trip down the floor. We've got 2 of the best defensive teams in the conference in terms of scoring defense.
Another chance for the Hokies to take the lead on this possession, and they'll talk about it. Timeout, Virginia Tech trailing by 1. Let's go back to March of 2015, the ACC tournament. The Hokies hadn't won a tournament game since 07. That would change against the Pack. Vanessa Paroussis had a game-high 19 points, but it was Hannah Young with a game winner. 57-56, the final. Back in 2015, in fact, they won 2 games that year. They'd only won two regular season games. They beat Pittsburgh and NC State to make the quarterfinals for the first time in school history. That represents the only win in the previous 19 meetings between these two programs, Virginia Tech and NC State. And there's your history lesson.
Well, we were at that game, and tournament is fun because things like that happen. NC State trying to stay perfect on the year. Virginia Tech looking for their first conference win of the season. Have played four top 25 teams in their first five conference games. The other game was against Virginia on the road, a rivalry game where they had a 19-point lead that Virginia came back to and win. And closing out games has been the biggest challenge for the Hokies.
Virginia Tech has possession of the basketball, trailing by one. 7 of 11 on three-point shots in the second half, and 4 of 5 from beyond the arc in the quarter. That's Emery stepping back. Came up short and to Crutchfield. Inside of 2 minutes to go in regulation. NC State had a 5-point halftime lead. Cassell traveled. Pack led by one after the third quarter. Down low, and the bucket. Gene for two. Virginia Tech has taken the lead. The eighth time the lead has changed hands in this game. Rogers driving by Gene. It'll spin on in for Stevie Rogers.
I like that take by Rogers. It's aggressive. It's late in the shot clock. Going to the rim. Good finish.
Emery trying to get that lead back. Leslie comes out of the pack with it. Seconds to go on the fourth. Pack by one.
Reagan McGarity guarding Leslie now. We've seen Leslie pull up and shoot the triple.
Leslie just inside the line. Gene went up for the board against Rogers. Out of bounds. Virginia Tech possession. 13 seconds on the clock and down by one.
Well, Alexis Jean, who we told you missed some of the beginning of the season battling injuries, with a big shot. And then NC State answers. Here's Dee Dee Rogers right back at her off the bounce all the way to the rim. The officials reviewing this now. This is the last play off the rebound to see whose hands it went off of. Rogers and Jean both going for it. Call on the floor initially was that it was Virginia Tech's ball.
Dee Kander, Kevin Dillard, Timothy Bryant. It is Virginia Tech basketball. Emphatically signaled by Dee Kander. Coming down to the final seconds.
Oh, and now Coach Brooks calls a timeout to advance the basketball.
Just the start of our women's basketball doubleheader in the ACC. North Carolina and Miami to follow us. Check your local listings. What a day inside historic Reynolds Coliseum. Westmore, the Wolfpack, trying to move to 18-0. Continue that school record start and school record winning streak. 17-0 is on the line against the Hokies. Now, Westmore has his full complement of timeouts, and he's going to burn one right now.
Virginia Tech, on the other hand, is out of timeouts. And there are 13 seconds left on the clock. Based on what you've seen here in the second half, Chelsea Shine, what are you looking for on this possession for the Hokies, trailing by one?
I think you want Emery with the ball in her hands. You'd like Regan McGarity on the interior just for rebounding purposes. You've got Baptiste in there for rebounding purposes, and then he has Mabry and Brooks on the perimeter as well. Certainly, as you see the score, you don't need a three. Something at the rim is where Virginia Tech has gotten success. I think you run Emery off the screening action and let her go to work.
Garrity on the inbound, trailing by one. 13 seconds to go. Baptiste and Emery, the double-digit scorers this afternoon for the Hokies.
And NC State has fouls to give here.
Emery, that's for three. Cassell went up and got it. McGarity converged on Cassell along with Baptiste. And a foul was called against McGarity.
Well, off the inbounds, Emery has a wide open look. It's early in the shot clock, but her team had time to rebound it. With that much space, Emery didn't think she could pass that up. Early in the shot clock, though, there's still 9 seconds left now.
Crutchfield on the inbounds. The coating stolen by Emery. She drives to the basket, and she got fouled. Leslie fouled Emery, who's going to the free throw line. With Tech down by one.
Stays in bounds, able to just snag that ball and then right to the rim. Redemption.
Emery, 3 of 3 from the line today. And she has tied this game at 59.
NC State still has 2 fouls to go before they're shooting.
It bounces off and Rogers grabs it. Immediate timeout, NC State.
Well, Tom, here's the steal off that inbounds. Koenig feels Emery kind of just lets her go, thinking it's going to go out of bounds. And then Emery, right to the rim, was able to keep her feet in bounds, draws the foul. And now NC State will advance the basketball, and they'll have a chance to win it.
Emery made 1 of 2 to tie the game at 59. That was the first free throw miss of the game for Emery, but she does have 11 points. Baptiste has 13. Now for NC State, Leslie leads the way with 21. Koenig has 17.
Even if she had made that free throw, NC State could have called a timeout to advance the basketball, and it still would have been a one-point game, so they still would have been going for a win. So certainly they wanted to have that rebound, but it's a very similar situation either way, where NC State will have a chance to advance the basketball and still be going for the win.
Credit Rogers as well. She got the rebound off of the miss. Leslie was there as well. And they called that timeout right away. Now they've got a chance with 5.1 seconds left in regulation. They'll move to 18-0 and 5-0 in conference play if they can put some points on the board.
Virginia Tech with fouls to give as well. They only have 2 as another timeout now. So Virginia Tech could theoretically foul 2 more times once the ball's inbounded before they would be sending NC State to the line to shoot in the bonus.
Just 1 timeout remaining now for NC State with 5.1 seconds on the clock. We told you at the top of the show, Virginia Tech might be 0-4 in conference play, but the record belies the talent level that the Hokies brought to the floor today, matched by the Wolfpack as well. Leslie to inbounds it. McGarity guards it. Two seconds left. Cassell, the shot, misses, and we're going to overtime, tied at 59.
Well, initially, I think they were trying to get Leslie with a backdoor. She inbounded the basketball and then immediately cut backdoor. That wasn't there. Cassell didn't have options. You can see Leslie inbounds to Cassell, cuts hard, well defended by McGarity, and then Cassell with no option but just to take it herself. Good job by Baptiste, defending tough. We talk about that Virginia Tech record, and one of those losses, the 0-4 losses, was to Syracuse, which was an overtime game as well. They lost that one in a close match.
That was the only overtime game this season for Virginia Tech on January 6th at home against then number 14 Syracuse, which has moved up to number 12 in the country. 75-73 in overtime for NC State. It will be their first venture into the extra session this season. Let's take a break. Catch your breath. 59 all. End of regulation. OT. Straight ahead. Back inside Reynolds Coliseum. NC State 17-0 on the season. Headed to overtime with Virginia Tech tied at 59. It was the steal by Taylor Emery. Late in regulation. Went to the line with 5 seconds left on the clock. Made one of two to tie it at 59. And Cassell missed the final shot attempt for NC State at the end of the fourth. And here we go with OT. Wolfpack controls. Koenig, she's made 4 3-pointers in the game. Crutchfield in the corner, nothing available. 21 points for Leslie, leading all scorers. Cassell leaning into Baptiste. McGarity helped out. Jean tried to pry it away. Held ball situation, Virginia Tech basketball.
You can see the fight out there. And they're going to get Cassell a breather now. She's been playing tough inside.
She got a high five from Wes Moore on her way to the bench. Don't forget, North Carolina, Miami to follow us. We're in overtime in Raleigh, North Carolina. Tom Wormy, Chelsea Shine, and our outstanding ACC College Hoops production crew with you.
See, that's one where you'd like to see Emery continue to turn the corner hard. She loves that free throw area, but might have the extra step on Leslie.
Leslie is 9 of 17 from the floor. 6 rebounds, 21 points. Coudain working the block against McGarity. It's Coudain. The freshman from Summerfield, North Carolina, has given NC State the 61-59 lead in OT.
See, Emery keeps getting Leslie up in the air, and I'm surprised she keeps looking to pass. You'd think she'd try to get that shot off. Watch here. She creates space, has the space, had already picked up her dribble, but such a pure scorer, I'm surprised she's just not routinely going up with that shot.
Coudain went up with the shot. Well defended by Baptiste. Coudain, the only points of OT so far by either team. As we approach 3 minutes to go in our first OT, Emery just inside the line, off the mark. Coudain to the court. Emery tried to wrestle it away, and a foul is called.
off the shot. They called a foul. Emery going for it as well. Getting Emery in for the reach.
Emery now just 3 of 13 in field goal attempts. Leslie straight away for 3, and that one is off the mark. There might be some tired players out there at this juncture of the ball game as we play in OT.
Both of these teams have had to deal with injuries, and we talked about and highlighted that for NC State.
McGarity driving and scoring.
Really good read. That's a read of a post player who spent some time in the guard position. You see you're able to attack your counterpart easily off the bounce. No help. That's a really good take by McGarity.
The senior from Sweden has 8 points. She's tied us at 61. Koenig to untie it with a 3-ball. Aislinn Koenig, 64-61. Emery driving baseline around Leslie, trying to get it back, couldn't do it. Crutchfield brings it up.
NC State, look at that, running the 4-out-1 in, good look. Inside to Kunane. They've been able to get the ball inside. Even when Cassell was in the game, they've been able to get the ball inside the paint. Stretching the defense, we talked about it, running that 4-out-1 in and allowing Kunane to go to work. Good pass inside, little face up. Tough take.
First free throw of the game from Kunane, who shoots 72% from the line. A soft bounce inside Reynolds Coliseum, and it's NC State by 5 in OT. 1:30 to go. Emery got bumped by Rogers.
Well, Rogers trying to come out for the high hedge on that screen. It's the right idea because you want to force Emery up high and away from the three-point line. Just clips her with her hip.
Trying to get it inside to Gene and the foul against Crutchfield, who was guarding Gene. First on Crutchfield.
Now that's a crucial foul because that'll send Tech to the line from here on out. In the bonus.
First free throw of the season for Alexis Gene. Remember, she missed the first 13 games of the year with a shoulder injury. Missed them both. Can't run it down. Koenig's got it for State. Inside of a minute to go in OT. The Pack trying to go to 18-0. Hokies trying to give them their first loss of the year. Koenig just inside the free throw line. It bounces out of bounds. Hokie basketball. Kevin Dillard was right on top of the call.
Well, another tough hustle play with Baptiste and Rogers, and the officials going to go look at it again just to make sure.
Bring Dee Kantner and Kevin Dillard are over at the scorer's table. This is the largest lead of overtime for NC State. Who's going to get possession here?
It's not on this tap. Watch, it's on the second tap. Baptiste comes in.
It looked like the left hand of Rogers. Again, the call on the court is Virginia Tech basketball. You must have indisputable video evidence to overturn the call on the court. Again, awarded to Virginia Tech.
And this is where you and I say we are glad we are not in the decision-making side of this.
At the conclusion of our game, we'll get you to North Carolina and Miami as we continue women's college basketball in the ACC. Paris Key, one of the most entertaining and exciting players in all of the ACC, will be on display as they are in Coral Gables to take on the Canes. 17-0. Will they make it 18-0? They've defended Virginia Tech well in the overtime. The Hokies just 1-for-4 from the floor against Wes Moore's defense at 0-2. The review continues. Our technical crew just gave you a great look. The second tap, the first tap, there were many hands involved in the touch, but the second tap, the key is the ball headed out of bounds.
And if the ball stays with Virginia Tech, NC State will have to guard without fouling, because again, any foul from here on out for NC State puts Virginia Tech on the line for two shots with the clock stopping.
Been overturned.
And then it must have been the right hand of Baptiste.
Pack basketball, 43.8 on the clock in overtime. Picked out by Brooks. Once again, that previous call overturned, and it went against Kenny Brooks and his daughter Kendall, defending the inbounds pass. Crutchfield to get it in to Leslie. Shepherd the foul.
Hokies foul number 2, Deja Shepherd. Shepherd's third personal, fifth team foul.
So it's Leslie at the free throw line, 1 of 2 in the game from the stripe for Leslie, who's got 21 points. Still well shy of her career high set at Boston College this season when she had 31 points and was 13 of 15 from the floor. Couple of big ones from Leslie, and the lead is now 7. 23 points, Tierra Leslie. And that number leads everybody this afternoon inside Reynolds Coliseum. But Garrity dribbled into trouble, taken away by the Pack, and a foul called.
And that is tough. Virginia Tech needed to get a shot off in that possession. McGarry attempting to go off the bounce again against Kunane and just fumbled it.
And with that personal foul, Reagan McGarry has fouled out of the game. Tough moment for the senior, who's played 112 games in a Hokie uniform. This one of the more exciting, but it appears the result will be in favor of the Pack with Leslie now. She's made 3 in a row from the line in the overtime session and 24 points. Timeout on the court. They're getting closer to hanging the 8. Pack 70. Hokies 61. Seconds to go in overtime. Tom Wormy, Chelsea Shine, and our
production crew documenting one of the most exciting women's basketball games to date this season. Tied at 59 into overtime, and Westmore's team pulling away. In fact, they've got their largest lead of the entire ballgame, 70-61 in OT.
Going on a 9-0 run, NC State, and a costly turnover for Virginia Tech, forcing them to have to foul. Now they call the timeout. It's the Hokies' ball. They advance the basketball.
You want to stay with us for North Carolina and Miami? Jen Hildreth, Kelly Dale, standing by. Once we're done here in Raleigh. NC State trying to win its fourth in a row in the series against Virginia Tech, and win its 19th in 20 overall meetings against this Hokie program. What an effort by both teams, worthy of Kayao Court here inside Reynolds Coliseum.
What an environment. Season high in terms of attendance. It's absolutely been an exciting game.
Emery needs to shoot it quickly for three. Koenig runs it down. Emery went for the steal. Leslie trying to dribble out precious seconds. And we're down to 20. Seconds to go. It took OT, but NC State will improve to 18-0. They're the only undefeated team in college basketball.
Well, Tom, if this doesn't say Virginia Tech is better than their record shows, I don't know what does. They're 0-5 now, have had a brutal start to the season. And a tough game, forcing overtime, but NC State marches on in the face of extreme adversity with the injuries that they've had. So impressive the job that Westmore has done, moving pieces around. And Kiara Leslie, the hero of the game, so consistent for the Hokies. A big-time scorer. She finishes the game with 25 points. Can score at every level, get to the basket, able to knock down the triples. Also did a great job defending Emery, I thought. Really limiting her in this afternoon matchup. Fun game today from Raleigh. And NC State hanging in there as the only undefeated team in the nation.
Koenig also had 20 points and made 5 3-point baskets for NC State. They're all smiles. They're 18-0. Once again, the final 70-61 for Chelsea Shine. I'm Tom Wormy. We say so long from Raleigh. We head to Coral Gables for North Carolina and Miami. And we hand it off to Jen Hildreth and Kelly Deo. NC State is 18-0.